Up, everyone. We're going to start off with some verbs right now. These are really common American verbs I want you to know. First one, kick things off, because that's what we're doing now. We're kicking things off. We're kicking off this lecture with a verb. Kick things off. It just means start. Get started on something. You can say you're going to kick off the new year, maybe with a big party or something. I could say I'm kicking off the week with a dinner. Kick things off. Now, you know that comes from football, of course. Literally, the game starts when someone kicks the ball. That's the origin of this phrase. Now we use it all the time to describe something that's just starting out. And by the way, it can be kick it off. Sometimes you'll hear someone wants to kick it off. I could have said I'm kicking this course off, kicking it off with some verbs, but kick things off is the full version of that. So now that we've kicked things off, let's move on to verb number two, and that is change things up. I'm changing things up if I make an adjustment, if I make a big change. For instance, if, I don't know, I started singing this class instead of talking it, speaking it to you, then that would certainly be changing things up. I can also say change it up. I decided to change it up one day and wear polka dot clothes. Just kidding. But that would certainly be changing things up. So anytime you make a change, you've changed things up. You've changed something up. All right, number three, cramp your style. This is a fun one. At a party, if I start criticizing you and say, don't wear those clothes or don't talk so loudly, if you feel like I'm sort of intruding on your right to do what you like at the party, you might rightly tell me that I'm cramping your style. Stop cramping my style, Noah. Mind your own business. Cramping your style means someone is trying to restrict you in some way. Don't let anyone cramp your style. All right, that's number three, cramp your style. Number four, do a double take. You ever walk down a street, for instance, and you see someone that you recognize, but you don't notice it at first, you sort of look away, and then something clicks in your mind and you look back because you recognized him? That's a double take. You just did a double take in that situation. Anytime you look away and then look back because you notice something familiar or maybe something strange. You can do a double take if you see some object that looks odd in retrospect. So doing a double take. There, just did it. That's a double take. I did a double take for you. All right, double dip. This one's fun. Double dip. It's really simple. If you dip your potato chip in the salsa two times at a party, after you bite into it, people won't appreciate that because they'll be afraid that you're spreading germs. That's doing a double dip. You double dipped. You dip your chip in or your carrot in or whatever the heck you're eating and took a bite before the second dip. It's really ironic that that expression, double dip, was invented on a TV show. You might have heard of Seinfeld about 20 years ago. That show popularized the expression double dip. And it's really funny to me because that expression is so popular. I would have never thought it was invented just a matter of years ago. It feels like it should have been around forever. I'm always saying it. People are always accusing me of double dipping. I hear that word a lot. But it's from Seinfeld, and it's really common and frequently used. So that's why I wanted you to know that one, double dip. All right, the next one's fun too. Getting off on, to get off on something. What that means is that there's something that you really enjoy. For instance, I get off on listening to smooth jazz. Someone else might get off on watching stupid TV shows. It's got sort of a negative spin. I often hear people complaining, oh, my teacher, she gets off on giving me bad grades. She gets off on criticizing my work. the teacher probably doesn't enjoy that as much as me or my friend thinks they do, but the idea is the teacher really likes grading my papers, gets some pleasure out of it. Ooh, he gets off on spreading rumors. She gets off on gossiping. So getting off on something means you really derive pleasure from it, and you probably do it a lot. All right, so that's getting off on something. Next one, give a shout. When you give a shout, it means you call me up. I might say, hey, give me a shout. If you have any questions about this course, give me a shout. Email me. Call me. Let me hear it. You're probably not really shouting. You might be speaking quietly, if that's your nature, but the expression is, you're giving me a shout. Hey, give me a shout. I'm going to give my friend a shout, see what he's up to. I haven't talked in a while. So that's giving a shout. All right, next one, hate on. Now, I'm guessing that you've heard of the word hate, the opposite of love, if you really dislike something. Hating on something or hating on someone is really hating publicly. Let me explain. If I took a course and I didn't like it, and I posted a lot of negative reviews, and I started complaining, and I started telling people, hey, this class I took was really bad. When the teacher tracks me down, the teacher might say to me, hey, I heard that you've been hating on my class. Why have you been hating on me? Why have you been hating on this class? It's like, why am I unnecessarily making a whole commotion about this? I could have just kept it to myself. When you hate on something or you hate on someone, you're making comments. You are maybe gossiping. You are being negative publicly. It's not private in your mind. It's what you're saying and what you're communicating. So hating on something, if you hate on someone, they might not like it when they find out, because that's a pretty negative thing to do. But I hear it a lot. Hating on something. Don't hate on me, please. Don't hate. The short way to put it. Don't hate. Don't be disrespectful. Don't criticize. Be positive. All right, that's hate on. A couple more in this lecture. We got kick back. Ooh, I like this one. I hope that right now as you're listening to me, you are seated down, relaxed, not standing up like me. I hope that you are maybe lying down, sitting in a chair, maybe you got your feet up, you're comfortable, bottom line. That's what I mean by kick back. I hope that you've kicked back. I hope you're kicking back at the moment. It's actually short for kick back and relax. That's the full version of that expression. I might say, now that you've heard this lecture, kick back and relax. Take a break. Think things over. Don't stress. Over the summer, vacation. I always like to kick back on the beach or on a boardwalk somewhere and enjoy myself. That's kicking back. Kick back. Hope you get a chance to do that soon. All right, and finally, lose it. Lose it means a few different things, literally. Lose weight, lost keys, lose it. But the informal, fun meaning I want to talk to you about is what I hope you don't do very often. If you lose it, that means that you lose your mind, is actually the long version of it. You don't have it together anymore. You basically go crazy. Maybe we're talking and I say something you don't like and you start yelling at me. You have a meltdown, as we say. You really just spaz out and lose control over yourself. Maybe you got some bad news, you got a bad grade on a test, something bad happened to you, and instead of being calm about it, you lost it. You started screaming. You really had a meltdown. You didn't keep yourself together. You weren't very composed. You lost it. Often afterward, you say, oh, I'm sorry, I lost it. I admit it, I lost it. I didn't handle myself very well that day. So that's lose it. By the way, another way to incorporate that into your speech is, you ever hear use it or lose it? It means if you don't use your mind and keep your brain sharp, then you'll lose it. I'm not sure if that's true or not, but that's another meaning of it. All right, lose it is your 10th and final fun verb for this lecture. We got a whole other section of verbs in the next lecture if you want to check out. So don't double dip too much. I'll catch you on the next one. Take care.